Our next guest says Attorney General Eric Holder has been warned and must comply with a subpoena to put forth all of the documents requested on the Fast and Furious gun walking operation before Memorial Day or face contempt of Congress charges. We're joined now by Congressman Trey Gowdy of South Carolina, member of the House Oversight Committee investigating Fast and Furious. Congressman, good to have you here. Let's start with, first of all, do you really think this Attorney General is going to do something differently in the next couple of weeks than what he's done over the course of the past 14 months?
Well, something new happened today, Lou. We got a 15-page letter, which I have not fully read, from James Cole, who's one of the senior DOJ officials, explaining why they haven't turned the documents over. And he offered something of an olive branch. In case my Ambien doesn't work tonight, I'm going to save this 15-page letter and read it then. So at least, you know, perhaps their attention was gotten some last week that some of us are serious about complying with this subpoena.
You know, and you've requested about 93,000 pages. You've gotten about 7,000 documents out of that. And now comes, there are a lot of reports running around that Congressman Issa, Chairman Issa, and Speaker Boehner at odds on whether or not to proceed with great vigor and energy here. Boehner apparently wanting to kind of push things off until after the election. I think this is where I say it ain't so.
Well, in complete candor, Chairman Issa asked me and another representative to take a lot of documents home with us 2 weeks ago to gear up for a contempt hearing. And then when I came back to D.C., that contempt hearing was off. I haven't spoken to Speaker Boehner about it. I've spoken with his staff. They tell me that all options are still on the table. I think after a year, that's enough time. You wouldn't get a year to comply with a subpoena. I wouldn't get a year to comply with a jury summons.
Yeah, let me ask you something. I mean, what happened to all of Congressman Issa's words, written and spoken, about the family of two federal law enforcement officers killed by weapons from Operation Fast and Furious, about all of the whistleblowers who've been held in limbo over the course of this entire period, who've stepped forward, had the guts and the sense of duty to do so? I mean, this is treacherous stuff, isn't it?
Chairman Issa's position has not changed one iota, and I probably ought to best leave it there. Chairman Issa is as resolute and committed to accountability as he has ever been. He also is not the Speaker of the House, and he's not the Majority Leader, and he's not the Whip. And I am hopeful, if I'm given a chance, I would hope that I could prove to them by whatever standard they wanted me to prove it to, that this is not a political exercise. Yeah. I guess I could understand being wary of doing something for sheerly political reasons, but this is not about politics to me, and I would welcome the opportunity to sit down with the Speaker and convince him of that.
Well, Congressman, I think that that you and Chairman Issa certainly should have that opportunity. And I think that if politics are getting in the way of a process here of oversight, that's a terribly, terribly unfortunate, even tragic circumstance. We will follow this, obviously, as closely as we have your investigation itself. We thank you so much for being with us. And by the way, persuasive is the 54 pages of documents, 54 pages of the memorandum of encapsulating of what you've established to this point, plus the draft document for contempt charges to be brought against the Attorney General himself, which I would urge everybody to read. Congressman,
you know,
as always. Yes, sir, go. You get the last word.
What's the use in having a majority if you're not willing to use it to do what is right? If this were about politics, I wouldn't be on your show right now. So we have the majority. Let's do what we know to be right and enforce the respect for the rule of law.
I understand that, and that's also one of the reasons you're on this show tonight. We thank you so much. Congressman Trey Gowdy.
Thank you.